Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. I'm going to give you the latest updates on what's coming around the corner. This extreme heat has gotten more intense and going deeper into our country of the lower 48. So I got new information for you on that as well. Plus, you can see for our tropics, you can see that tropical depression Alberto has formed out of Invest 90L. Still going up to northern Atlantic. No threat for anyone. Matter of fact, you can see on the tropics, that big wave that came off yesterday got demolished bad by the dust. So if you're in the Caribbean, you can see all this dry air moving in. Matter of fact, the tropics in the Atlantic is about to shut down for a while, maybe all the way until the end of July before we pick back up with our hurricane season. No moisture is making it across. Now, right now, we still got our threat of these tropical waves that's going to be pushing towards the Bay of Campeche, towards southern half of the Gulf of Mexico, forming up towards western Gulf of Mexico, still potentially hitting some of Texas, Mexico, maybe even getting Louisiana. Matter of fact, the precipitation is about to switch over from Florida towards northwest. Now, yesterday, we did see a lot of that wind damage. We have over 150 wind damage reports, all the way from going from Kansas really hard, from Missouri through Illinois, northern Indiana, and through Michigan. We even had 3 tornado reports for western Illinois. Now, this is where severe weather is going to start milding away and really dissipating. So it's really going to be mild all the way until Sunday on Daddy's Day. Then on Monday, that 15% severe weather risk for that next storm system has shrunk down greatly as well. So here's the information about this heat wave as it pushes through, and it is going all the way into next week, all the way to the 20th. A little bit further, I will show you. But everything on this map, and here's your percentage chart over here on the right, probability of higher temperatures greater than 100 degrees. Plus, daily temperatures through Ohio Valley and the Northeast Monday through Thursday with max heat indices approaching 105 degrees. So please hydrate. Please prepare for these temperatures rolling through. So you can see this map that they have put out, and it has all the way from the 21st all the way to the 24th. You're going to be in that moderate section for all that heat coming through. Also for the Northeast, if you've been here before, you've seen me update this every single day. But also right here, this is where they're expecting some drought to increase for Indiana, Western Ohio, also for Virginia, Maryland, and some of New Jersey over here for the Northeast around the Mid-Atlantic. So there's going to be a lot of drought coming out of this as well. So remember, this link is in the description below, so you can go click and see what your temperatures and your weather will be like as well. As you go through Saturday and Sunday, remember, it builds into the weekend. You start becoming that major level. Once you go into Monday, this is where the extreme is still kicking. Tuesday, it spreads further east and north, and Wednesday hanging around some more. And once again, you can click on this anywhere you're at on this map. It will give you your temperatures that you need to be aware of as this rolls through. Also for Thursday, again, so it is growing and getting worse. Before, it took that away as you went from Tuesday to Wednesday. Now it's showing extreme again, and extreme all the way into Thursday. So just be aware, this is going all the way through this weekend, all the way into next week also. Now you can see on that pattern that the storm starts going away after about later on this afternoon for far southern Florida, all the way into the Florida Keys and northern Bahamas still. But you're going to start getting this storm system that's going to pop up, not only for the Central Plains, but over here for the Northeast. Got some storms brewing up. The Northeast just going to bring a little bit of chance for hail, not much. Over here for the Central Plains, as this goes late tonight into tomorrow, that's bringing some chances for some damage and winds with that, as we get that next troughing coming in from Saturday and Sunday and growing a little bit into Sunday and Monday as we go a little bit further. Remember, we got that 15% risk and it did shrink down. But all this is all going to be minor. Chances for damage and winds and chances for hail, but not a big chance for any tornadoes. And you see this on the laser National Weather Service for today. Your chance for tornadoes is going to be over here around the Central Plains. You have a 2%. So far, here's your cities and states at risk. Everything else will be for chances for wind, even significant wind in this black section. That is what I'm seeing. Also, chances for hail. So here's your cities and states at risk for the chances for the damage and winds for today. And here's your cities and states at risk for the chance for the hail threat for today. National Weather Service has scattered severe storms with large hail and wind gusts of 60 to 80 miles per hour will be possible from mid-afternoon through the evening along the Front Range to the Central Great Plains. Scattered strong storms with sporadic damage and winds and isolated hail will also be possible across Northeast states during the afternoon to early evening. And you can see severe weather for tomorrow. It is shrinking greatly. Your chances for tornadoes is slim to none. Still, so far, here's your cities and states possible at risk. This could just disappear altogether. Plus, you have your wind threat and your hail threat in the same locations for tomorrow, for Saturday. And National Weather Service has scattered severe thunderstorms are possible Saturday from the mid-Missouri Valley into parts of Wisconsin and from eastern Montana into parts of the western Dakotas. Wind and hail will be the primary concerns. Now, as you go through Sunday, you get a little bit of storms coming through. It has weakened down greatly. All you guys are a little 5% coming out of that. So far, here's your cities and states at risk. This is going to be chances for hail. That's about it. And you can see this from National Weather Service. Scattered strong and a few severe storms are expected Sunday evening and overnight from parts of the northern plains into the upper Mississippi Valley, with hail the primary risk. And then as that tightens up for Monday, look how much smaller and a 15% risk came. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for this, and it is going to be for chances for hail. So far, your chances for your damage and winds as you go all the way through Saturday, showing that will be a strong line of storms, bringing 50 and 60 miles per hour wind gusts with that potentially all the way till Saturday morning. And you get that band and still going to the 50 and the 60, persisting all the way to maybe western Iowa. So be aware of that. Then as you get that trough going all the way until Sunday, it will continue into Monday also. Bring in chances for 50 and 60 miles per hour wind gusts with that also. So it is bringing some strong winds with that. However, the hail don't look like it's that big of a deal. You do see chances for small hail, maybe even a little bit bigger over here for Nebraska. But as you go further, as you go towards Saturday into Sunday, maybe towards North Dakota, not showing a big hail event neither. Showing those storms will bring some rainfall. You have 1+ inches in all this purple, but you go in 2 and 3 inches plus in all this red, especially in this brighter colors. So it is bringing some rainfall with those storms though. And you can see for the next 7 days, as it goes less and less for Florida, it is transitioning over southern Mississippi, Louisiana, and Texas and Mexico. All that red is 2 to 3 inches. Once you go to that orange, you start going towards 5 inches of rainfall coming. Now you can see the latest tropical update with Invest 90L, Tropical Depression Alberto. It has 20% chance in 48 hours, 20% chance in the next 7 days. Plus, over here on Disturbance 2, it is at 50% chance in the next 7 days, and possible a tropical depression could form as we go into next week, maybe even strengthen even more. This will be Beryl. And then that third one that's potentially still forming up, that would be potentially Chris. But now showing on Invest 90L, it would be on Alberto, showing it does have a chance to become a tropical storm now in the next 36 hours, and later maybe strengthening up again. The only one that's going crazy is the ship. Now remember, the ship is always crazy on these, and it never trends with the rest of them. It might become a tropical storm. Plus, what's over here in the eastern Pacific is dwindling down to 10% because the main focus, the main piece of energy is going to be over here in the Bay of Campeche. Now, our latest update on our potential velocity anomaly shows that 50% has a lot of favorable environment also, and the wave getting pushed, merging together with the GFS shows it even stronger today than yesterday. When you look at the difference with the Euro, it also shows a lot of good favorable environment for that 50% to grow into next week. But you also see with GFS season, it has shows more strength since then, a little bit further to the east, but it's showing some more favorable environment, a little more than it had for yesterday. Looking at our latest chance for tropical development in 72 hours, all the way up to 5 days, starts pushing it over here where that 50% will grow into next week. Then you can see as you go 6 and 7 days, starts going western into the Gulf of Mexico. So this will be where it more likely will form. I've been seeing this a long time ago. But then that second one starts getting a chance to form as we go 9 and 10 days. Another chance right in the same region, particularly doing the same thing, pushing north and west as we go into the 20s. Shown literally by your cyclone locations, as we go 4 days away, it can start forming up a low pressure, maybe get a tropical depression, maybe a tropical storm. And you see in 5 days, it gets pushed to the west by the high pressure. Then that next wave comes in, showing a weaker chance of formation, but still showing some stragglers that it could happen. But look how much weaker these are starting to show for the chance for that to happen. Maybe at the last minute, some of these are showing last minute formation And a lot of these is showing a lot weaker of a chance. All I can do is keep showing you the latest updates so we can keep following the new information as it evolves. So by the time National Hurricane Center talks about it, we already know what the outcome is, what we need to prepare for, and what is coming. That's why I like to do this early. I've seen on the news a lot of people saying they had no warning whatsoever what happened in Florida. And I warned people 2 weeks ago, and exactly what I warned is what happened. So hope everybody is okay down there. It's going to start receding and getting better. I know it's not draining well. Now you can see right here with your GOES satellite. This is your dust coming through. This is all the way till Monday. There's that tropical wave that is just forming up. And you see how it pushes to the west, but it sits there and spins for a little bit. Maybe we gathering a little bit of strength, but you also get some dry dust that gets involved in there. I don't know if it gets all the way to the core. It don't look like it on this shot. It might strengthen up and still try to head a little northern, but as you go by Wednesday and Thursday, then it gets pushed strong to the west. Then we got that next one forming up over here by the Western Caribbean, still showing our next possibility. But you can also see at the same time, you are getting dust going into that, possibly keeping it where it will remain something weak. That would be a great outcome if it'll just follow the same theory and keep pushing west, bringing Mexico all this rainfall. Now, it will cause them a lot of flooding. They do need this rainfall, but it will be a lot of flooding. But you got all this dust pushing behind it, and this is going to close your tropics. Other than dealing with this, the tropics will be closed. Agreeing that it will form up some kind of surface low, maybe a tropical depression, maybe even a tropical storm. While it goes by next week, gets pushed to the west because you have the high pressure setup. You can see this here. It's pushing everything in this general direction. But then after that, then we get our new pattern where the high pressure comes over towards Bermuda. You get our Bermuda high. And then the next group of precipitation agreeing that it will start pushing in this general direction, a little more of a northerly track. So we do need to watch that one. I think that one has the best chance to head further north than what we have now. Still showing about a Euro chance for formation on that first system, showing the same thing, pushing to the west, bringing rainfall on the northern and eastern side of this system as that pushes to the west. And then maybe that second one forming up and is showing it a lot weaker for today. Now keep in mind, this is the last couple days of the run. This always changes back and forth just in generally because it's just too far to be accurate, but I will keep you updated. The main thing is to stay with the trends. When you look at the ensemble control member of the Euro, the long range, it agrees on the first one, maybe a little bit of strength at the last minute might form up towards Mexico, and that second one showing today more likely will remain weak, maybe get a tropical depression at the last second, and that's about it. Whatever comes on land, it's been trending that we're going to get another trough coming through. It is going to carry through the lower 48 and out through the northeast. The Canadian is agreeing also it could strengthen up on that first disturbance that we're dealing with as that goes through from Wednesday, and that second one could potentially start to head north but then get pushed immediately to the west, almost like what we're dealing with now. And this is another thing that worries me. You see GFS, of course, taking a little stronger. It's what GFS does. Keep in mind, this is not trending on the strength, but you see it does take it towards a hurricane towards southern Texas, but then it revolves around for multiple days, and then becomes a major hurricane again in the same location, finally squeezing to the north. And this is sitting there literally from Sunday all the way to the next Friday and Saturday. We're talking about a week. That would give me some Harvey vibes. That is not trending. One thing that worries me, though, is our balloon data runs. Our 0Z and our 12Z balloon data runs always show a lot more intensity, always show the western side of the Gulf of Mexico. When we go by the 6Z and the 18Z, these are not balloon data runs. They take it where it just turns towards Florida and towards the southeast, eastern side the Gulf of Mexico. So we got to watch for what this high pressure is doing over here and how far to the east in the Atlantic does it form up, which allows everything to either come eastern in the Gulf or come western into the Gulf. Just what I pay attention to mostly is the trends. Secondly is balloon data runs. These 6Z and 18Z, I don't believe these because balloon data is more accurate, and the 0Z and the 12Zs has been showing the western Gulf of Mexico, where it's favoring with the Euro and it's favoring with the Canadian. Also favoring maybe a tropical depression, something a little bit stronger, not showing anything bigger in the trends. And you can see this change when you look at the GOES satellite, when you look at the whole basin, as we get that first system, that 50% that we have now, as that starts to move out, you can see the high pressure swinging everything in that general direction. And then as you go further into transition with that next one, you can see the high pressure where it's setting up and generally bringing everything in that direction, right on a northerly track. So that's what you got to watch for. Mostly you can see it's doing a little swiggly, little S-turn. So we need to watch out for that. Matter of fact, the latest updates when we go by our weekly events, as we go from the 13th through the 18th, you can see all the favorable environment that is really over in this region for growth. Then as we go from the 18th to the 23rd, look how much less it has shrunk down for your favorable environment. After this, we're about to go into a lot of unfavorable environment, and this dust will persist through. So as we go towards the end of June into July, we're going to go into that unfavorable environment, and the Caribbean will be closed from any hurricane activity. And that's because we have all this dust pushing through. So if you follow me in the Caribbean, I did see someone tell you they have something big that just come off the coast of Africa. You don't have any worries. I'm still showing you have no worries. The dust ate that wave, and it's going to continue to persist through as we go towards the end of June all the way into July. No formation coming in your area. So if someone tells you you have a big hurricane, a big rare wave coming your way, it's a lie. The tropics will be closed. And you can see this from your latest update with the long range with the Euro on your potential velocity anomaly. Your favorable environment, all this blue that we have in this region, bringing our favorable environment on that storm that's going to be in the Bay of Campeche, and what comes after, potentially weaker, just like you've seen in the short range as well. Then you got all this unfavorable environment coming in all the way until the beginning of July, right into our region, all the way from the Caribbean, all the way to the Gulf. This is the dust persisting through. And so far in the latest update, we might get a system in the eastern Pacific as we come back from that break and still be somewhat in a break as we go through July. So that would be a great start for me. I would love to see, other than what we're dealing with now, no further formations all the way to the end of July. Give people time to prepare and get things they need, because it is going to start picking up later on. I just believe we're into a slow start. And you can see here from your hurricane names in the Atlantic, we do have Alberto with Invest 90L. Beryl will be what forms out of what's 50% now into the Bay of Campeche. And if this forms up afterwards, it will be Chris. And that has been the latest information, so I hope this has helped you understand what is coming around the corner. Thank you again for your time, everybody. And thank you to everyone that helps share the video and helps hit the like and get this out to more people. Let them see what's going on, because there's nothing coming in our tropics anytime soon other than what we're dealing with. We will be on an extended break for a while, and our severe weather is going a mile down. But the heat is going to pick up, so make sure you use that link in the description. That way you know what to prepare for. Make sure you stay hydrated, check on your neighbors, and check on your pets. And before you go into this weekend, Psalm 118, 24 through 29. This is a day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Save now, I beseech thee, O Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. Blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you out of the house of the Lord. God is the Lord, which has showed us light. Bind the sacrifice with cords, even unto the horns of the altar. Thou art my God, and I will praise thee. Thou art my God, I will exalt thee. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Amen. Have a great day and have a great weekend, everyone. Thank you to everyone that does help around here. I do appreciate you so much. And remember, all glory always goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe, you and your family, and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you again on Sunday.